In this video, we're looking at a spring hanging vertically, and we're going to attach a mass of 850 grams to it. We observe that the spring stretches by 18 centimeters before it comes to equilibrium. So this is its new equilibrium position set by the force of gravity. In part A, we're asked to label all the forces acting on the mass and then compute the spring constant. And in part B, we want to get the period of oscillation if we displace it from this new equilibrium position and allow it to begin oscillating. So for the force diagram, there are two forces acting on this mass. It's the force of gravity acting downward, the spring force acting upward, and those two have to be equal in order for this thing to be in equilibrium. So our upward pointing spring force has a magnitude of kx, where x is the displacement from the original length of the spring, and our downward force is mg, the weight of that block. So just working symbolically for the moment, we have kx equals mg in order for this thing to be in equilibrium. We solve for k, and we get mg over x. Now we can just plug the numbers in, make sure you convert that mass to kilograms, 0.850. We'll use 9.8 for g. And then x, the displacement from the equilibrium length of the spring, is 0.18. Into three significant digits, we get a spring constant of 46.3 newtons per meter. Now to compute the period of oscillation, if we displace this mass from its equilibrium position and release it, the period is just given by the formula 2 pi square root m over k, and I'll post a link to the video where that was derived using calculus. When we run the numbers on this, we get a period of 0.851 seconds. And that's it. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.